Okay, hello everyone. Y'all want to take a look at day 40, the puzzle piece assignments. There is a worksheet key here already. And if you're online, you don't have to do the worksheet. But the two puzzle piece assignments, we'll look at them right now. I'm going to put them under the dot cam. Guys, the first one is the homework check. Starts with the essential question. How do we divide and simplify radical monomials? That's what we're doing here today. You can get that in the PowerPoint slideshow or in the video too. All right, question two, again, this is on the homework check. In order for a radical expression to be considered simplified, it cannot contain three things. Well, what are they? Guys, they can't have a negative exponent. They can't have a radical in the denominator. And they can't have a fractional exponent in the denominator. And in a way, these are all three the same thing, in a way. Again, you have to rationalize the denominator. You can't have an irrational number in the denominator. All right, please submit that. We'll go right to the exit ticket here. All right, question number one. Pretty easy, guys. Again, the square root of 4 in the bottom is 2. So there, we rationalize it. Pretty easy. All right, number two. Not as easy, all right? There's a square root of 3 down here. We got to get rid of it, all right? The top is already square root of 4, so that's 2. So we still got to get rid of the square root of 3, though. So I multiply the top and the bottom by square root of 3. This is multiplying this number times 1. It's just a clever use of the number 1 to get rid of the square root of 3 on the bottom. The square root of 3 times square root of 3 is just 3, and that's what we want. And then 2 times square root of 3 on top. And that's your answer. All right, guys, number 3 here. Again, first you can recognize that 8 has a perfect square in there. A perfect square factor, 4. And you might recognize that 100, the square root's 10. So just 30 times 10 on the bottom. Or 3 times 10 is 30 on the bottom. The square root of 4 is 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. Now, this isn't quite simplified because I can still divide the top and the bottom here by 2, which is what I do right here. And that's your final answer. All right, number 4. There's a negative here, so your answer is going to be negative. But there's a square root of 3 down here, so we got to get rid of it. Again, top and the bottom by square root of 3. So the bottom just becomes 2 times 3. That's 6. And the square root of 3 is on top. And remember, it's negative. All right, number 5. Again, separate these two into the perfect square factors. Factors here that are perfect squares. All right, this top one, 4x squared, that's a perfect square. And the bottom one here, x squared, that's a perfect square. So on the top, all that's left over here is 1x, and that stays inside. On the bottom, what's left is 3x, so that stays inside. Now, the top has an x squared inside the radical, x squared inside the radical, cross them both off. And this top here has an x squared inside the or an x in the radical, and an x in the radical, cross them both off. So all the x's disappear, which makes sense, guys, because right here, there's 3x's on top, 3 on the bottom. They're both inside a radical sign. They're all going to disappear. So all we have left is 2 over square root of 3. And we get rid of that square root of 3 the same way we know how. The top and the bottom by square root of 3. So the bottom just becomes 3. And the square root of 3 now is on top. All right? All right, number 6. Again, I divided this into perfect squares. Right, guys, 16 is 4 times 4. Now, I could leave the 16 together, but I want to separate like that because it looks exactly like the bottom. So that's a perfect square, 4. And that ends up being 2. And this is a perfect square right here. I took it out. And what's left then is xy on top inside the radical because I took out 2 of them, but there's 3 of them in there, so there's going to be 1 left. But the bottom has 2 x's and 2 y's, so I take them all out. There's none left. All that's left is a 5. And that 5 came from 4 times 5 is 20. So these all cross off. The top, all that's left is 2 times the square root of xy, right there. And the bottom just has the square root of 5, which you got to get rid of. And this is how you do it again, the square root of 5, top and bottom. So take the square root of 5 inside the radical and put it underneath in that radical, right there. You can put the radicals back together. And square root of 5 times square root of 5 is just 5. All right. All right, number 7. Again, 7 has a 3r in the bottom. So multiply the top and the bottom by the square root of 3r. The square root of 3r cannot be on the bottom. So the bottom just has 2 times 3r now. All right, and 3r on top times 2r squared is 6r to the third. All right, I can take an r out of there because there's 3 of them there, the square root. Take the 1r out. The 3s cancel out. And here the r's cancel out. So all that's left is the square root of 6r over 2. That's all that's left. All right, the last one. Again, I recognize on top that 20 has a perfect square factor, 4. 4 times 5 is 20. And I can take both x's out. They're perfect squares. Put that all in the perfect square here. Right, the bottom is 2 there. And again, I can take 4x squared out. That's a perfect square, and it leaves me with 3x in the radical. So that crosses off. The 4x squared inside the radical crosses off top and bottom. Right, the top 4 divided by 2. If I divide both those by 2, I just leave 2 on top. So that's where that 2 came from. The square root of 5 is left right there. The bottom just says the square root of 3x, which you have to get rid of. And you get rid of that by topping the bottom by 3x. So the bottom now just becomes 3x because the square root of 3x and the square root of 3x just equals 3x. And 5 times 3x is 15x inside the radical. And that's it. Thank you.